Welcome back to the Practice Norwegian podcast and episode 8 of the Basic Grammar series. So today we're going to talk about the reflexive pronouns and then two other items of grammar. So first, the reflexive. So this is like when you want to say, for example, I dress myself, or I lay myself, I hurry myself, then you have the set of pronouns, which is mostly the same as the object form, but slightly different when it comes to he, she, and they, because then you have the word seg. It's written seg, and you pronounce it seg. So you have jeg og meg, du og deg, and then you have han og hun and seg. And then you have vi and oss, dere og dere, de, and then again, instead of them in the object, you have seg as the reflexive. So for an example here, if you want to say I get dressed, you say I clothe on myself. So you could say jeg kler på meg, I clothe on myself, meaning just I'm getting dressed, I get dressed. And then you would say du kler på deg, and then han kler på seg, he is dressing himself or getting himself dressed. And you can guess this one, hun kler på, good, seg, so it's the same, hun kler på seg. And then you have vi kler på oss, so we are getting ourselves dressed. Dere kler på dere, you are getting yourself dressed. Use it a lot if you have children, two or more children, you say dere, dere må kle på dere. And all the other ones, dere må skynde dere, dere må legge dere. So dere, dere is very common if you have special children. And then de kler på seg, they get themselves dressed. So just remember, it's like the object forms, except for he, she, and they, then you have seg. So you can try this one now. So I'll just leave a little gap and then I will say what it is. So if you want to say I go to bed, you say I lay myself in Norwegian. So the first one is then jeg legger, good, meg. Jeg legger meg, I go to bed. Du legger deg. Han legger, good, seg, han legger seg. Hun legger, the same, hun legger seg. Vi legger oss, that was a bit fast, so vi legger oss. Dere legger, dere, and then de legger seg. Yes, good, de legger seg. There's a slight thing with pronunciation here. If you have in Norwegian R and S after each other, even if you have two different words, the S becomes a sh sound. Like, if they're together, you can say like kush, it's like a course, or Norwegian, norsk, because you have R, S. If you say legger seg, the R and S are after each other, so then you say legger seg. So seg is the s sound by itself, but if you have an R in front of it, it becomes the sh, like seg, han legger seg. Okay, one more you can try. I hurry myself. Like I said, just the first one. Jeg skynder meg, I hurry myself. So du skynder deg, han skynder, great, seg, hun skynder seg, vi skynder oss, dere skynder, yep, dere, dere skynder dere, de skynder, yes, great, seg, de skynder seg. Okay, so that's the reflexive pronouns, and then I'll just explain a few very common phrases or examples of reflexive verbs. For example, å glede seg is to look forward to something. It's kind of, glede is happiness, so you're happinessing yourself, that's when you're looking forward to something. And it's a kind of a physical feeling, it's like you just feel it inside of you, like emotionally, physically, that you enjoy before something. Like a vacation or the weekend or meeting someone or just watching a great movie or something. Glede seg. Gifte seg is to get married, so you say you marry yourself. Grue seg is the opposite of glede seg, so grue seg is to dread something. Å legge seg is to go to bed. It could be to lay down. If you say legge seg på gulvet, then it means like you're laying down on the floor. But as a general, just a phrase, expression, it means to go to bed. And then you have sette seg, is to sit down. You sit yourself down. Og skynde seg is to hurry yourself. Og snu seg is to turn around, so turn oneself. Og komme seg, this is an expression. It means to get better, kind of to recover or to come yourself back to the healthy state. So people say, har du kommet deg? Have you come yourself? Meaning, are you healthy and happy and good again? And then, jeg har kommet meg. I have gotten back now. I have come back now to healthy. And then, kjede seg. This is how you say to be bored. So you say that you're boring yourself, even if it's not you who is boring yourself, but you just feel it. You're boring yourself inside of yourself. And then, gjemme seg is to hide yourself. Føle seg, this is a bit important. Like if you feel, you're feeling about your own health or your own mood or something about your own body, you would say, use the reflexive. Jeg føler meg glad, jeg føler meg sliten, jeg føler meg trøtt, jeg føler meg stor I dag. So then you would say that. If you feel something about something in the room, or you feel that something, you would just say, jeg føler at noe galt, like I feel that something is wrong. But if you're, and again, referring to yourself and your own state of mind or physical state, you would use the word seg. Jeg føler meg glad I dag. And then, bevege seg is to move yourself. Og ta på seg is to put on, like one item of clothing, for example. Ta på seg hatt, ta på seg jakke. Ha på seg is to have on yourself. That's also like one item. Ha på seg, the same, hatt. Ha på seg en genser, ha på seg lue. And the last one is å lene seg, to lean yourself on something. Lene seg på veggen, lene seg på stolen, like you're leaning yourself on things. Okay, so that's just a handful of useful expressions. And again, it's used a lot more in Norwegian than in, for example, English. Okay, then two other items of grammar, short ones. The first of those two is, if you want to say, says that, you would use the words sier at. He says that it's sunny. Han sier at det sol. So sier at means says that. If you want to say the phrase ask if something or ask about something, you have to use spør om, ask about. The most important thing with this expression is just you can't say spør hvis in Norwegian. So in general, if, like hvis means if. But in Norwegian, every time you use the word hvis, you need to say the consequence. So like, if it's raining, I'm staying home. But if you then say, can you ask if we can go home? In Norwegian, then it will be like a vacuum. Yes, if we can go home, then what? So that's why in Norwegian, or if you think in English, ask if, you have to translate to spør om instead. So, a couple of examples. Han sier at bussen kommer klokka fem. He says that the bus comes at 5. De spør om veien går til sentrum. They ask if the way goes to the center. And now you can try to fill in. They say that everyone must remember their lunch pack. De sier, good, at. De sier at alle må huske matpakke. And then he asks if they can go home. Han spør, good, om de kan gå hjem. Han spør om de kan gå hjem. Okay, and then the last one, the last item of today is the imperative, or if you're giving commandments. So in Norwegian, the way you do the make that this tense of the verb is you take infinitive and you take off the vowel. So for example, å huske is to remember. If you're giving the commandment, you're telling somebody to remember something, you would just use husk and no e. Husk dette, remember this. Same with, for example, to wait or vente becomes just vent if you want to say wait or wait a little bit. So you can't say vente litt, you have to say vent litt, because vent is then you're telling somebody something to do. And then we have komme, to come. So you can say kom hit, for example. That's like come here. So then you just have kom. Other ones would be sit ned, sit down. Vær stille, be quiet. Spis maten, eat your food. Hopp høyt, jump high. Rull rundt, roll around. So many of these would be kind of for if you have some a nice little pet, or if you, what you say to your kids, like spis maten, and vent litt, kom hit, hør etter, listen up, hør etter. Okay, so a part of the effect of this is just you make it shorter, so it sounds a bit more like you're telling someone to do something. So sit down, go there, come here, eat your food. Okay, so that was the last item of the grammar, and we're going to stop this episode here. So, as always, thank you so much for listening, and see you again soon.